to be on one of those sets, to be in one of those projects, to work with him, that's for a lot of people. That's like that's it. That's the goal. And for you to have checked that box off at such a young age, it's such an amazing thing to have achieved and done. What was that experience like? What was it like being on that set and being around that guy?
I mean, it was an absolute dream. I've looked up to him for so long. I've had a Pulp Fiction poster next to my bed for many, many years, and he's been my favorite filmmaker for forever. So to be able to watch him in person doing his thing and be able to learn from him and observe him was really like, it felt like being in school, but a million times better, and I learned so much more than I ever did in school.
There's no better classroom.
Absolutely.
Than on that set and be there in the thick of it and see it happening in real time.
Yeah.
He notoriously, very famously, no cell phones on a Tarantino set, which typically, not a big deal. You are a person of a younger generation. Was that a challenge to be without your phone for some time?
It's so sad that could be a challenge.
You'd be surprised what we hear. But
No, totally. It was actually one of my favorite parts about the film because we did have to check our phones in every day. Yeah. I at the beginning, I just kept my phone in my car because I was so scared to even bring it anywhere near. I was like, honestly, just someone steal it. I was like, oh my God.
What's the phone?
Yeah, I don't even have a phone.
I'm writing letters. I don't know what you're talking about.
I'm being really messy. but it ended up really being like my favorite part because it really forces you to connect with people and to talk to people. Right. So I made some of my best friends on that film. Like Mikey Madison, who plays Sadie, is now one of my best friends in the world. And that's because we had so much time to sit down and really connect. And I couldn't really divert to my phone if I was ever uncomfortable talking to anybody. So it was like, we're talking, we're singing songs, we're reading books, we're playing games while on Spawn Ranch. And that just allowed a lot of beautiful relationships to be made, so it ended up being like one of my favorite parts of the film.
Is that you were just in that world.
Yeah
that's pretty incredible. You mentioned something in telling that story that I didn't even think to ask you about, was just, what were you thinking the night before the first day? Like, how nervous were you, like, for day one, like when you were gonna like walk on to a Tarantino set? What was it like the night before? Did you even sleep?
Oh, no, definitely not. I pretty much read, like, every single book I possibly could on the Manson family in that era, and every documentary, and I just kept rewatching stuff at a certain point. So I'm pretty sure, like, the night before, I was just rewatching every documentary I could possibly could, and on the way, I made a playlist of music from that time, and I would listen to it every day on the way to set. And I just, it was so surreal. I couldn't believe it. It still feels kind of surreal.